Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in North Carolina still. Extended my time here so I can get everything resolved to drive this RV temporarily, brothers and sisters. Anyway, God bless all you guys. I have a word from the Lord, and the word from the Lord is a civil war in the church. Civil war in the church is coming. Civil war in the church is coming, brothers and sisters. And I want to tell you what. This is the deal, the problem with what people don't understand is that, you know, the enemy's not at the gate. The fact is, within the church, there is only a remnant of real Christians. That is the bottom line, no matter what denominations you go across. There's a few wheat. There's a few sheep and or wheat in almost every denomination, brothers and sisters. Now, I just saw, and I haven't had time to talk about this, I saw, of course, Kenneth Copeland, who calls himself a little god. He got, you know, they had that conference with the Pope, all loved up with the Pope and all excited about it. You've got James Robinson, who I even, you know, before when I first started out, when I was looking for a place to do my tithing before I started in the full-time ministry, I gave to help, you know, dig those wells in Africa. If you ever watched James Robinson and his wife, they're nice people talking about digging wells in Africa for water and all that. And way back, that was in 2001, 2002, 2003. And now he's there high-fiving with the Pope. And I want to tell you guys something. Just reminding me of someone, you know, I'd made a video and I said, only born-again Christians will go to heaven. And then someone messaged me, commented and said, well, how can someone be a Christian if they're not born again? Well, that's why I said that. It's to clarify, there's Christendom. When you say Christendom, you're talking about everything, even maybe the Mormons and Jehovah's Witnesses and Catholics and all this other stuff. And then Christianity is the true body of Christ, born-again Christianity. And then Christendom, all that includes all these other kind of cults and all that stuff. So I want to tell you this. Jesus didn't rebuke the sinners and all that. Like you, I hear lots of Christians who are going out here talking bad about, which is true, there's lots, Islam is evil. We know that. Islam, the religion, is evil, and it's about jihad and all that stuff. We know that. Holy war. But people who are Muslims, lots of them never heard the gospel. They don't know any better. The lost, the maimed, the halt, the blind. Jesus said when you have a feast, invite the maimed, the halt, the blind, and all that. All these people in the world don't know any better. But the people that Jesus rebuked was the Pharisees, these religious, self-righteous people. Now, you're talking about Judaism is one thing. You're talking about, because the modern-day rabbinical Judaism comes straight out of Phariseeism. It's the same thing. They've replaced the Word of God. They've nullified the Word of God by their traditions, as Jesus said. They made the Word of God in none effect by their traditions. So that's one whole thing. But you know, the Lord didn't call me to Israel, even though by the grace of God, I can minister in Israel as the Lord would ever allow me. But the Lord had called me unto the Gentile, unto the nations, unto the Goyim, the church, the Gentiles of the world. Okay? To the church, to the body of Christ. Okay? And so, when you put that in the same context, the Pharisees are those self-righteous people in all of these denominations who are not born-again Christians, who are trying to get to heaven by their works. Okay? So now I've talked about this many times, but it's been a long time. Okay, let me just say this. The definition of a cult is a group. Now, I don't have the exact words in my head. It's a group that has a leader, and that leader can hear from God, and nobody else can hear from God. And that leader's words are the same authority as the Word of God. And they're giving you revelations and all this kind of stuff and saying, hey, this is equal to the Bible. And this is equal. I am in the place of Christ, the vicar of Christ. Now, as an example, the largest cult in the whole world, you're talking about Jehovah's Witnesses and Mormons and all that, that is just a drop in the bucket, brothers and sisters. The Civil War is coming really when the Roman Catholicism starts being the ones to enforce the mark of the beast on everybody else. Even though I do not agree with the Seventh-day Adventists and the things that they teach, okay, about following the law. But I do believe there will be enforcement of all this stuff. There will be enforcement. And I believe it will come through Roman Catholicism of Sunday, you know, Sunday worship and all this stuff, trying to force that on the Jewish people, force that on all these other groups. I believe that's really going to be part of it, brothers and sisters, as the Lord has led me and showed me. Now, let me just put a disclaimer in here. I don't debate with anybody about it. You can go to church any day you want. Every day I celebrate Christ. Go read Hebrews chapter 3, verse 6 or 7. along in there through the end of Hebrews chapter 4. And you will see that we have another Sabbath rest. It's not a day. It's a constant rest by faith in the finished work of Christ. The Old Testament Sabbath points us to the rest, like God rested on the seventh day. Ours is a rest that's by faith in the finished work of Christ. That's what the Sabbath was. It was a type and shadow to point to resting in the finished work of Christ. That aside, I have nothing against people who want to go to church on, have church on Saturday, Sunday, or whatever they want to do. You can have church in your house. You can have it Friday night. I've started churches, and I had, you know, I started one because people worked. They were nurses, so we had it on Friday night. And they told me, oh, do I still have to go to church on Sunday to go to heaven? They would ask me that, even after I've been teaching them for years. You don't have to go to church to go to heaven. The churches, you can go to church, or you don't have to go to church. All churches are full of tares, full of weeds, full of demons, full of devils. The biggest battle is in the church. If you can't stand all that foolishness, just stay away. Start your own Bible study. Watch videos on YouTube. Find some good preaching that might be on some on TV. Whatever you can do. Fellowship with your fellow believers through the internet. Whatever you got to do. Have a Bible study in your house. Whatever. Wherever two or more are gathered in my name, there I am in the midst of them, the Lord Jesus Christ said. Now, I'm trying to talk to you about the coming civil war that's coming to the church. Or to the Christendom. It's going to be between the true church and these false religions, cults. Now, all of these mainline Protestant denominations, they're even worse. They deny the virgin birth. They deny the divinity of Christ. They deny that he's God, all that stuff. I'm talking about your mainline Protestant denominations. They've all got gay bishops approving gay marriage, all that. I'm talking about the Presbyterian USA, Lutheran, Methodist. All these denominations are all the same. Baptist, now there's even a Baptist preacher I saw. He's an Asian guy, but it's in America. Baptist preacher, his son came out as gay, and now he's saying, okay, gay marriage is great. And I believe he's Southern Baptist. I might be wrong. One of these branches of the Baptist denomination. You got Kenneth Copeland, who thinks he's a god, a little god. James Robeson, these other Pentecostal preachers, loved up with the Pope. You know, the reformers were right. And their part that the reformers gave is still right, brothers and sisters, even though they might be wrong about some other things. The reformers were right. Martin Luther was right when he said that the Pope is Antichrist. He's standing in the place of Christ, exalting himself above Christ, all that is called Christ. When he says that my words are infallible, anything I say as the Pope is equal to or greater than the Word of God, it supersedes the Word of God. I hear Catholics, I read their comments, and I know what they say, hear what they say. They say that we gave the world the Bible. No, you didn't. God gave the world the Bible. The Bible comes from the Holy Spirit of God as he gave it to men as they were carried along by the Holy Spirit. The Lord gave us the Bible. The Lord orchestrated the canonization of scriptures. Not any man, not any church. The church is not over the scripture. The church is under the scripture. Mary is not the mother of God, not the mother of the church, but a member of the church. Mary was there with 120 when the Holy Ghost fell, fasting and praying. She wasn't over the, she's not the mother of the church, but a member of the church. Jesus said, you shall call no man father, because you have one Father who is in heaven. But yet, this biggest cult in the world, people don't see it as a cult because it's so big. It's like 1.2 billion people. So people say, oh, you know, they think of a cult. They think of a, you know, a secret hidden group of 100 people that hide and worship, and the guy, you know, like David Koresh or something like that, or Jim Jones or whatever. No. A cult, as I told you, a cult is a group that has a leader who gets special revelation from God that deviates from the Bible, who goes and says, here, I got this secret word. If you follow me, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except by me, standing in the place of Christ. So the Catholic Church says you must die in a state of grace in order to enter heaven. How can you be in a state of grace? Only by participating in the sacraments of the Roman Catholic Church. They have like six or seven sacraments. You know, becoming a priest. Well, you can't do that. Getting married, taking the communion, sprinkling water on your head, which they call baptism. But the word baptismo is a Greek word that means to submerge in water, to immerse, to submerge in water. So, sprinkling water on the head, as I mentioned in a video before, when I first got into the ministry, that's a whole nother video. I'm just going to talk about people, the things I've dealt with, brothers and sisters. There's coming a civil war in the church, brothers and sisters. There is coming a civil war to the church. but it is the true body of Christ versus the devil's children, the tares, the goats. And I want to tell you something, brothers and sisters. There is a pre-tribulation rapture, but I do not know how much we have to face. You know already, I don't know what Christians are doing. They're being quiet. The only loudmouth preacher I hear is John Hagee, but he's loudmouth about politics, Israel in the flesh, Israel in the natural, and politics. And you know, that's part of a Christian. We should defend Israel. That's no doubt about that. But I don't hear any preachers. Maybe there are a few who are calling for holiness and repentance of the church, calling for, you know, like a John the Baptist, Elijah calling, that it's time for repentance. It's time to return to the foundation of the faith. That's the Lord Jesus Christ. There's probably few and far between doing that. And then most of the viewers, like on YouTube, they're running to and fro trying to find out what day is the rapture, instead of occupying till the Lord comes, instead of doing God's will. And I'm telling you, I've been putting out this warning. That's who God called me to put out a warning to as I'm making these videos. You who are running to and fro, you who are a mile wide and an inch deep, you who are trying to calculate the day of the rapture, you are running around doing your own will, just only worried about your own self, trying to escape. You're the very ones who's going to be left behind. You're the very ones who will take the mark, the very ones who will be deceived and delusionally confounded, as the Lord himself will send a strong delusion on this world at that time of the rapture, after the rapture. A strong delusion is coming on this earth. And it's coming from God. It's coming from God. Not from the devil. It's from God. God is sending down his judgment. He's going to say to you who keep running to and fro on YouTube, wanting to find out when the rapture is, he's going to say to you, when I was hungry, instead of feeding me, you were counting the square root of your shoe size times the circumference of the earth times how many points James LeBron scored in the game divided by his jersey number. Try to calculate when the rapture was. When I was in prison, instead of visiting me, you were on YouTube arguing with people over if there's a rapture or not. And when I was naked, instead of clothing me, you clothed yourself in your self-righteousness and declared how you were going to go into rapture and how great you are, how great thou art, instead of how great the Lord is. I'm cautioning you. I warn you. I beseech ye, brethren, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, pray always that you be counted worthy, that you be counted worthy to escape the tribulation and stand before the Son of Man, Luke 21:36. What must you do to be counted worthy? Humble yourself. God says he gives grace to the humble, but he resists the proud. Humble yourself. Repent. Call upon the name of the Lord. Change your ways to repent. Change your mind. Change your ways. Go in a new direction. Go out and invite those who were uninvited to the feast. Stop entertaining and compromising with the devil's children in the church. These tares, these weeds, these cult members. Stop compromising with them. God didn't call us to compromise and work out all of these things with these cult groups. The Lord called us to go to the blind, to the maimed, to the halt, to the lost of this world. Go evangelize the Muslims. Go evangelize the drug addict. Go evangelize the prisoners. Go evangelize the scum of the earth in the eyes of man. What's called the scum of the earth in the eyes of these rich people? Those who are beneath them. The people that are just the nobodies who don't know anything. Because that's who God can work with. God can't work with these big, glorious, self-made vessels. He can only work with that raw clay that's nothing but dirt that's just crushed and busted and torn all to pieces. That's the clay that God can work with. Brothers and sisters, I challenge you in Jesus' name. Let God's will be done in your life as it is in heaven.